Welcome to this reflection video, where I will discuss with Bas and with Ellen the examples of innovations in the water chain in Amsterdam and Kampala that we've seen this week. So Bas, what can you tell us about Kampala?
Well, Kampala is a special city, but representative for the Global South. A city, fast-growing city with problems in providing the infrastructure for water and sanitation. Only 6% of the population has a sewer system, connection to a sewer system. So the rest of the people have to deal with that themselves. So out of necessity, you have a lot of co-created solutions for water and sanitation, as we have seen in the examples in the informal settlements of Kampala. Citizens create their solutions themselves, or mostly together with the informal sector, with NGOs and community-based organizations. An example that we have seen, the Pipu Bag, which was a typical example of an NGO providing kind of emergency sanitation for people in densely populated areas. And these bags were being used and utilized by the people themselves, and an organization is meant to collect and to treat the material in it.
Yes, but the context in Amsterdam is very different, Ellen. What can you say about innovations in the water chain there?
Yeah, it is indeed an entirely different context with a well-developed, highly dense infrastructural system. At the same time, we can learn from each other, and sometimes we have innovations that are quite similar. So to collect the medicine residues in hospitals, we've got the road bag, like the ones that truckers use to collect the medicine residue and to prevent them from polluting our wastewater. So that's an example of a very low-tech innovation that can have a tremendous contribution to the water quality. But also from a water quantity point of view, there are innovations possible, and also citizens play a crucial role in there. So we've seen over the past decades numerous innovations like water-saving showers, water-saving taps, water-saving toilets. And now it's time also to think of some leapfrogging innovation, more radical innovations which radically reduce the water use. And the splash, the water-saving showering system that has also been introduced in the videos, that is an example of such an innovation that has been developed together with citizens, but that can really make an impact and a real difference to the way we use our water and the quantity we use it.
Yes, so there we have seen actually that citizens are some sort of co-designers. Mm-hmm. But what other roles of citizens have we seen this week?
Well, a very good example was the role of citizens as monitors of the water quality at the end of the drinking water system. The water company has asked consumers to check the quality of the water. Yeah. And that is, of course, for a water company a tricky thing, because they are responsible for water quality and they normally don't want to bother consumers and don't want to get them worried. But in this case, they really asked citizens as monitors. And it worked very well, because people were very much involved and knew more about the system than before and felt co-responsible for it.
Yes, this creation of awareness of including citizens in the innovations, not just in a particular part of the chain, but in the entire system, that is highly relevant, because it also makes the different actors aware of each other's role in the system. And for example, you can also make use of the different roles actors have. Like citizens, they are also investors in innovation. They're also the users. So when you have citizens on board and you develop innovations that are really crucial for the entire water chain, you increase the demand for such innovations as well, which can take along the industry designing and supplying such innovations to the citizens.
Okay, thank you, Ellen, thank you, Bas, for this reflection on Amsterdam and Kampala. And thank you for joining us this week.